Hello everyone and welcome to Usitility. Today we are going to see how to play Evertale on PC using the brand new BlueStacks 5 that is designed for blazing fast speed and high octane action. We will be able to easily download and install Evertale and enjoy the game on our Windows PC with keyboard, mouse and big screen thanks to BlueStacks 5, which is the Android emulator that we recommend to play Evertale. So without further ado, let's get to it. Before anything else folks, to get started we have to launch our main web browser. We have here the one we prefer. Let's continue, going to that URL that I'm highlighting in green color. Now, you can see on the screen. There is no need to type anything, because I provided the link in the description of this video and the first pinned comment. We arrived here on our website of Usitility, in which we find here a detailed explanation on how you can download and install Evertale on personal computer. We browse down a bit and click on the Download Game on PC button. After we click on the link, we reach the website of BlueStacks, which the Android emulator that we are going to use to play Evertale on the PC. It is now obvious that we have a great deal of advantages of preferring using that emulator. Then, we will proceed to download the Evertale by clicking on this button Play on BlueStacks that you can visualize here in green. We then click on it. Of course, the download starts and ends immediately. Here it is, here is located the download. It's a file to execute. What we have to do is to launch the installer, okay, then we click on the file. Windows 10 users will be asked for permission to make changes to the device. We answered yes. I reduced the browser to view the installer better. The installation software is very simple to use. It includes two choices, install, and setup path. I am going to clarify what setup path really does. We only simply click on it. And now we see that we get here the path where your emulator is going to be set up. If we want to modify this directory we are required to click on this browse button, and we opt for another folder and install the emulator precisely where we prefer. I am going to keep it by default. Then, I click on back. And therefore I click on install. Great, the installation starts and it will move forward with the download of these megabytes that happens to be shown on that screen. At the time you download it, it may be more or less megabytes. The data transfer rate may go at a higher speed or slower, subject to your web access and depending on the efficiency of the emulator servers. Right now they're running superbly fast. The download is finished, and now it proceeds with the installation phase. With BlueStacks 5 you can even reduce RAM usage with a single click. Especially useful if you ever face performance-related problems. In addition, you can activate Eco Mode to enjoy 87% reduced CPU usage, 97% reduced GPU usage and easier multitasking. As you can see, BlueStacks 5 is built to provide stability and performance during long gaming sessions. The installation has already finished for me. At this point, the emulator has been launched automatically. As you will notice, down here, there is a progress bar that will fill up and once it reaches the end, the emulator is going to be started for the first time. The reality is the emulator has already been launched, here it is for the first time. Before we continue on, as you can discover, it made two software icons there on the PC desktop. The BlueStacks and BlueStacks Multi-Instance. Note that the BlueStacks icon will be the only one we're concerned about. When we want to launch Evertale on our desktop or laptop, we double-click this app icon and consequently launch the emulator. The BlueStacks Multi-Instance icon allows you to launch multiple emulator instances. And with BlueStacks 5's new improved Multi-Instance Manager in Eco Mode, players can run more game instances faster and with less lag. We should do the next step, which is a requirement, and that is to enter the Google Play Store. And we are going to click on Play Store. As you will notice the Google Play is launched. There we have to log on. At present when we are here, we have to conduct the next step which is absolutely mandatory. So that we simply click on Sign In. At this point it says Checking Info. It may sometimes get blocked in Checking Info, that's why it does not move ahead. In that case, you can try to log in after a couple of hours and it will surely probably be repaired. At this point we are going to type in our email and password. The email address must be a Gmail email and its matching password. As an example you may use the same email you use right now in your own YouTube account. Then I am going to type my data and I'll come back after I have done it. That's all, data inserted. Here is Google welcoming us and supplying us the terms of service. We will say yes to all of them simply by clicking on I agree. After that, it offers us to backup to the Google Cloud. You can let it checked and it'll produce a backup of your data files on this device to Google Drive. I will not check it, you do what you want. We click on accept. The Google Play Store is launched by default and automatically. To set up the application, we need to visit the emulator desktop by simply clicking on that icon marked green colored. Today that we are on the desktop of the emulator, we notice that we find here the install video game button. We then click on that button. Right here we have the video game. So let's press here on the install option that I am showing now in green. Therefore it will start the setup. Now it would download and install the video game, it usually takes a bit of time or perhaps it could possibly be very fast. That all will depend on the internet access. It has just finished setting up. Back to the emulator desktop by clicking on that button that I'm highlighting in green, to be able to run Evertale for the very first time. I am at present on the emulator desktop, then we're going to just click on the new Evertale icon that's been provided. That game is launched for the very first time. Now there we end up with it, I can click anywhere on the screen and also make use of the keyboard. I am going to comment on the volume of the emulator. It's here. We have the icon of higher volume and also the icon of lower volume. This manner we don't rely on the Windows volume to increase or decrease the music of the emulator. As well as to enjoy the experience to the max, we can switch on the big screen, for which we have two options. That is the first one, we click on this particular app icon that I'm mentioning in green color. Then the screen is maximized, getting one border on top, one at the right and one at the bottom. Supposing that we desire to appreciate the game using all the screen, we click this app icon. And we might by now be enjoying the game app in full screen mode. To leave the complete screen setting, just click the F11 key. And therefore we would by now be in regular screen mode. At this moment I am going to reveal you the keyboard mapping that is certainly very appealing. This strategy we will probably be capable to use the game app more effortlessly. The first thing is to press this keyboard icon. It's now time to make the necessary configuration settings. I am going to keep the default settings, though if you plan to modify it, you may very well do it now without any problem. As you can notice, the emulator is completely in our language. Sometimes it occurs that the emulator is launched in the incorrect language, for instance, in Chinese language. Then to set it in the correct language we browse here to the cogwheel. So here within other options, we click the language drop-down. We can opt for the language we like, Italian, Mandarin, and so forth. When the language is chosen, we could save, the emulator would reboot, along with the Android game, the next time we start it, would as well be in the chosen language. At this time, there is another aspect that we must take into consideration, and this is that we will receive an email indicating that a different equipment has been linked to our Google account. It definitely will question us if we are the people who have connected that electronic device. Yes, we may not get worried, because the emulator is acting as an Android electronic device. And then to see which electronic device is being emulated, we return here, to the cogwheel, and we simply click on it. And so we go here to the model option. And here we notice that the emulator is emulating a Samsung mobile phone. And so we're going to receive an email saying that a new Samsung device has been connected to our Google account. This is it folks, so much for this tutorial. I anticipate you appreciated it, especially that you found it interesting. In that case, offer it a good thumb up, subscribe, and any feedback, concerns or ideas, leave them in the comment area down below. You can also comment things on my Twitch channel, I perform live streams ever so often, you have it listed below in the video description and in the very first pinned comment. Simply click on any of the instructional videos which are usually appearing on the screen and let's have fun again in the future online videos. Bye.